So we have to ask ourselves, what is the reason that our home gets destroyed? If you know why the holy temple got destroyed, you can figure out why your home getting destroyed. Obvious. Let's start with the first house and move into the second house. The first house was destroyed. This is what they said yesterday, last week. And I want you to repeat it again. I will be happy to repeat it again. That last week I said that the reason that the person has to be respect, especially a man to respect his wife so much, is because the way that you're going to be respecting your wife. The Gemara said, if you want to become rich, 10% is good. Shabbat is incredible. But the Gemara said, okir b'ulat hashayim, respect your wife, you're going to become rich. What's the connections? Respect your wife and you're going to have a blessing. What's the connections? Respect your wife, you're going to have customers. Respect your wife, just getting married. The Gemara said, anyone that gets married is being happy with you. Now, women love it. They always come to the classes to hear it. Rabbi Vaknin is good. It's good. Why are you talking about that? Hey, says, I'm coming next week. Come on. Come to me. My husband is here. But what's the connection? Nobody knows what the connection is. Torah is not politically correct. We're not politicians. I'm sorry, we're Israelis and we're rabbis. If nothing is a source, if there's no source for it, if there's no logic behind, I will never tell you. I'm not telling you because I want your wife to feel good. I'm telling you because the rabbi said. And why did the rabbi say it very simply? You see, we also got married with God. Do you know that? We and God got married. When exactly we got married with God? When exactly? How do you call it? Which other things? Which other things? Shavuot. The holidays of Shavuot, but not Torah. We got married with God. We're reading Torah. What's the name of the Torah? Torah. God gave us the Torah, 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 that you gave away. Now, if the Torah is the Torah, who is the groom and who is the bride? Who is the bride? Who is that? No. The Jewish nation is the bride. And who is the groom?
God.
Why? Now, what's the problem with this? God said, if you want me to act with my groom, how do you act with your wife? The way that you act with your wife, but you also the wife, the way I'm going to act with you. You know when a poor man is coming to you and he's asking for charity and you're making a sour face, not only that, but if you came twice and asked him, you looked at him like, hey, I don't understand, I just gave you $5. You give him $1 and you're already going out with this. Why are you coming twice? Enough is enough. Why are you coming to ask me? God said, no worry. Which goes around, comes around. When you're going to come to ask for me charity, you're going to say, God, I need parnasah. I need lucky when you're coming 3 times a day. 3 times every day. Shacharim, minchayna. God, please. Atachonim, barech alem, barech. God said, why are you coming 3 times? I already gave you the $5 before. The same way that you act with a poor human being, the same way precisely that God will act with you. The same way that you act with your wife, precisely the same way God is going to act with each one of us. This is our role model. If this is so, listen to this. Beit HaMikdash HaRishon got destroyed because of 3 sins. Idol worship, adultery, and murders. Right? Idol worship and relationship. Anyone here can tell me what is idol worship and relationship? What's the idol worship and relationship with the husband and wife? Can you explain what's the idols? No, not what is adultery. Not what is immorality. What is idol worship and relationship? What, bending over? And what is idol worship?
The idol.
Don't take Moshe lightly. You know what's idol worship? And many of us are doing it. Not in this room, everybody. When we are angry, especially when we are angry, But the main thing, each one of us think, maybe I can find something better out. Maybe I can find a better wife. Maybe I can find a better husband. How many times do we fight this yet? Maybe I made mistakes in this marriage. No, God, the first commandment is, I am your God, and you will never have any other God except me. I am your wife, I am your husband, and we are together. Until I have to do. Hello to you. Idol worship is the thought that we believe that we can find something better outside. Chutzpah, audacity, arrogance. Who do you think you are that you can find? Say thank you that you went to. I don't know, maybe she will talk. You come with attitude, you don't look. Don't look at me like this. I'm in the house. I mean, because of me, you are alive. She was alive before she met you. And by the way, I will say it quiet. She had much greater life. Next to the parents, she got everything. With you, she's getting, but she has to make money, cook, clean, and get in sleep, and abuse, verbally abuse, it's okay, all of it. And she is with the parents. Jonah was not my daughter. My daughter is She used to get breakfast to the bed. Breakfast, sunny side down, Shakespeare with love, cappuccino, mochaccino, cappuccino. With you, if she doesn't make the coffee in the morning, what a face, that I may wake up and there's no cappuccino then. Yes. Wait a minute, what's that? I don't know what you mean. Do you really believe that you can find anything better than your wife? Your husband is God's gift. And God doesn't do mistakes. And God doesn't do mistakes. The false reason for the distraction from your home is the night I don't worship. The second reason is adultery. Immorality, listen to this. I will tell you what is immorality, but again, today, we are in fun. Each one of you that came tonight is a lucky man. Jonathan said, Rabbi, go deep, go deep. He went to Cape Town to make mistakes. He said, Rabbi, we know that we have the best teachers. He said, the BJCC is behind. Don't blow, go ahead, go ahead, don't blow. The place to be. Yes, yes, don't worry. I'm coming. Don't worry. You see, the new faces is always there. They're afraid, they don't know how to run. Shmuel, already, why? Shmuel, you're not a rookie anymore. After 1 year, you're not a rookie. You have to sit here. What's this? You know, I had new guys, new students. You know, some students, they feel very comfortable with the rabbi. They come to me and say, Rabbi, you're going to love it. I said, Rabbi, you're a Jew. He said, what is a Jew? I said, what is a Jew? What is a Jew? Jesus. Jesus, that's it. What is it? It's good enough. I don't know what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm really nervous. Your brother don't know what you are. But I did it for so many years. I made last week a young thing and put it back. I'm giving you my word. I'm giving you the word. About this is a decent word. In a simple way, immorality, adultery meaning having in mind someone else except your husband and except your husband. I'm not talking about actual wives because Baruch Hashem here at these tables, front of the synagogue, nobody has a shalom. God forbid will ever cheat physically wise on his wife or on his husband. Out of the question, our community knowing to be a normal community, a blessed community. Physically wise, nobody cheats. Thank God, Baruch Hashem, Baruch Hashem. I will be very happy to continue to believe that in our community there are this few in this city. Even though that Moshe mentioned it beautifully, the iPhone, the smartphone, and all these nonsense that bring to our life so much garbage, to our mind so much garbage. But still, at least action wise, we don't go so far. But immorality nowadays, to this מסתכל על הקדוש שלי, מחשבות זרות. מחשבות זרות. אני אפילו לא תמוד בגודים ובגודים. די שביט פרשה. And I know that you're going to repeat it in the tables. And this is the only class that I can say it. And this week, Parashat, Parashat Matot Masei, we mentioned 2.5 tribes, 2.5, that didn't enter Israel. They stayed outside of Israel. Do you know what's the name of these 2.5 tribes?
Reuben.
Gad. Half a minute. My question to you, why these 2.5? And by the way, the question is even stronger. Why half? Was it racist? I don't understand. If you take in half, take the whole of it. Why Menashe is only half? And why the Reuben and Gad is outside? Gentlemen, what exactly they did? Imagine yourself, 4 years it took you to get to Israel. You come in on the border, and Moshe Rabbeinu said, we are outside. Why half? I know. Why half? The God between your husband and you, long ways, and a half a life, that's a question. My husband is a lucky man, no doubt. And you're going to raise with your husband and children, and succeed in the Shomayim, and the Lord. בתוך הרחבה, בדרך חיים, בגלל נדיף, והכל בהרחבה בזה. My name is Rabbi Vaknin, my name is Rabbi Vaknin. No, this is stop, why how? Why how? Why? Listen to this. People ask me, when in which moment in life, by the way, if you know this answer, why these 2.5 stay outside? Why these 2.5 stay outside? Free holy schnitzel in the house. You have lunch with your wife, but not holy schnitzel. Kebab, steak, balagan, be loud. If you know the answer, holy schnitzel is on the house. Anyone know the answer? Anyone know the answer? Imagine if you know the answer, holy schnitzel on the house. Never. Listen to this. I will tell you the answer. There are many answers. But this one, one of the best answers that you will ever hear. When is the best moment to influence a child's life forever? To make the child life that you're going to have a tzaddik. And which moment is the moment that you can influence the child's life?
Forever.
There are one moment. If you made it in this moment, that's it. Which moment? You said, what's his name?
Mashiach.
No wonder why we're an example. Anyway, the rabbi forget the name Mashiach. Why? You're not that. How can you forget the name Mashiach? You can forget Yonatan, you can forget that. Mashiach. Your wife said, I need Mashiach, but not my husband. I need one. I need another one. Oh, Hashem, I got Mashiach. Mashiach. What do you say, Dominic? What do you say?
The time of
conception. Listen to this. And the time of conception. How do you say? Conception. And the time of conception. And the moment that the woman conceived, in that moment, it's very rare to know how, which day exactly. But if you know which days, because of that, the minute that the person has a relationship, you have to be very, very careful in his mind. His mind has to be very pure. To think about tzaddikim, to think about, not to think only about physical needs, physical enjoyment. We're not animals. We are much greater. Not to think about, you know, only enjoyment, no. To think about what kind of child. Because what's coming out from the body of the husband, the sperm, is coming from the brain. Everything comes from the brain. If this is coming from the brain, the moment that you thought, what's going to be in that Mahshava in this moment, Rishi Korma, many great and Kabbalistic books, suicide. Is that the sandak? And is that the moen? And is that the thing that he came to the world? Is the day that the wife can see. Wow. If this is so, I will prove it to you. Listen to the proof. Listen to the proof. You're going to, your mind, if you're going to share it in Shabbat, when you're going to go to any other synagogue, please share it. There will never be such a chidush, such a unique idea that you're going to be careful from now. Listen to this. Yaakov Avinu, when he got married with which woman?
Yeah.
Well, no, which woman Yaakov Avinu got married with? The first one, which woman he was supposed to get married?
Rachel was supposed to be married.
So he got married to who? Rachel. No. Not supposed to. He got married to Rachel. Leah switched at night. They switched. I mean, when he said, I had the conditions, he didn't see that it was actually Leah. It was not Rachel, but in his mind, the Kiddushin went to Rachel. When he went up, he was one with Rachel. He wake up in the morning, become, so his mind was with one woman, and happened to be, even though that it was a mistake, the child that came, what's the name of the child?
Reuven.
He's not holy enough to go to Eretz Yisrael. The mind of Yaakov Avinu was missing. What do we say that the time that a woman can see is the time that we influence? That child have a little spiritual defect, not physical defect. Reuven was Kodesh Kodesh, Chet V'Shalom. But because of these mistakes that Yaakov Avinu didn't know about it. So let's move forward. Leah had how many children?
Six.
And then she had another daughter, right? Six boys and one daughter.
Yeah.
Now, if this is so, after Leah stopped from having the children, Rachel brought a maid. What? Concubine. Okay, she had a maid. The maid got married. What's the name? What's the name of the maid?
Bilhah.
Bilhah. You know how you know Bilhah? That's important. You know how you remember? Because to have a baby, the number hay after a baby. Our letter hay is a letter that brings children. So when people call me before, when they have a children, which name to choose to the babies, especially a woman, I always like to have the letter A among women. They are much more easy to bring children. So Rachel Avinu is the only woman that have more A. Leah, hey. Sarah, hey. Rivka, hey. Zilpah, hey. Bilhah, hey. Everything is a success, Rachel. Rachel Avinu had a difficult time to bring children. You know what Yaakov did? He brought a maid with two hay. One for her, one. What's the name of this woman? Bilhah. Bet Lamed hay. Why? Two hay is going to be. So because of that, he brought this woman with two hay. Now, she brought the woman, she has a child. Leah was jealous. How come she's bringing the cucumber? And she said, I also have weight. I'm going to bring my man. But you know what Leah did? Leah did the same act what they did before. She didn't tell Yaakov that she's changing. She just told Zilpah, you're going to go tonight. And you're going to have a relationship with Yaakov to bring all his children. Again, Yaakov is going to sleep with who? Leah. Wake up with who? Zilpah. What's the name of the child? God. That's the name. Huh? Outside. So where is it?
Very good.
Come to me. It's only the beginning. No. Are you ready?
No, I didn't
know about the second one. No, they are hard for men to make
for
sure.
Before they got married?
No. He got married. But in the relationship, she told that this is even more instead of me. She didn't inform Yaakov of you.
Again. They asked trying to be with Yaakov.
Exactly. Now let's continue. Where is the half of Menashe, what's that? Now she didn't know. She didn't know. Where's the half of Menashe? We're missing what? So we know Reuven, we know God. Where's the half? Listen to this. Don't אומרת, listen to that. The half of Menashe. Who is Menashe? Menashe is the son of who?
Joseph.
The son of Joseph. Who is the father of Menashe? Who is the mother?
Astat.
Who is Astat?
The daughter of Dina.
Astat is the daughter of
Dina.
From which relationship this Astat came from?
Shem.
You remember that Astat was raped by a boy?
Dina
was raped by a boy. So she had a daughter. The name of the daughter is Astat. Now, none of the brothers, none of the holies, the holy tribes wanted to get married with this woman because she came with rape relationship. She came with a goy relationship. Nobody wanted. You know what they said? They sent her to Egypt. She went to Egypt. They gave her a calf, a letter, a hidden letter, signed by Yaakov Avinu that you are a Jew. That's it. But she went away. It was embarrassment. Embarrassment to have a child that is raped by a goy and the children of Yaakov Avinu. So she went away. She came into Mitzrayim. She became married to who? To Potiphar. You remember Potiphar? So the wife of Potiphar gave Yosef. Why? Because with all the women want to get married with Yosef. All of them want to get married. Everybody says, you know, you see a beautiful guy. Yosef was one of the seven most beautiful men in the world history. Guys, as much that you are beautiful. And I know that each one of you every morning look in the mirror before you put the mousse. Who is the most? Who is the most handsome guy in the world? Let us be men. God don't to me. But he was a person much, much beautiful. No offense. His name is Yosef Atzadik. Women, when they used to see him, they used to cut their fingers and not feel in the blood because just to see this beautiful person. You know what you do in salads, especially Israeli salad? And you see Yosef. Then finally, it becomes meat salad with blood and flesh. Don't ask it. Now, all the women told the jewelry on him. You know what Esther did? She tore that leather on him. He opened the letters and what did he see? A letter from Yaakov Avinu that signed the Jewish Jew. Yosef said, I'm going to get married. So, now they have a children. They have two children. Two children came out to the world, Menashe and Ephraim. If we have two children, the father of Yosef is Yaakov and Rachel. Everything is perfect. Yaakov and Rachel. Perfect. The father of Asnat, the parents, is a half a goy, half a goy, half a Jew. Dina was a Jew, but the father was a goy. Half and half in the children, supposed to be half and half, right? We have two children. Cut it to four, how much we have quarter? We had to take half of Menashe, you know what? The half of Menashe came from the influence of the relationship of the grandparents by the name Chamor ben Shechem, or Shechem ben Chamor, a goy that raped a Jew. Now you understand why we have it? We had, what? No, because Menashe is the Bechor. Usually if you realize, all the negativity come on the Bechor when they have something bad in the family. Ishmael, the first one, came by the gun. Esau, the first one, came by the gun. Anytime that you have the first one, Reuven was a little by the gun. Every time you realize, you see, none of the huge leaders in the world was a first born. If you realize, most of them, David HaMelech was not the first. Moshe Rabbeinu was not the first. Yaakov Avinu was not the first. Abraham Avinu was not the first. Yitzchak Avinu was not the first. Nothing. So if you're not the first baby, feel good. You have a good future. If you are the first one, eat them all. Either you're the guy, either you're good. No, eat them all. I say eat them all. I'm not making money back. Eat them all. Eat them all. And you kids, come on. Mr. Shalom, you choose right. You choose right. Don't move.
All right, Balagan is a good thing or a bad thing? Balagan is a good thing or a bad thing?
Balagan depends which direction you take in this Balagan. So now we understand that what you have in mind in the time that we conceive, that the wife conceive, will influence the baby forever. That child that come 9 months later, either to become the greatest tzaddik, or either to become average. You want your child, and that fault that you have, this is adultery. This is immorality. Immorality is chas v'shalom, is to have machshava that is not kedusha. We're going to end with this one. The last one is avodah zarah gilui v'shpichut damim. Shpichut damim, today I'm going to take to two different directions. With this, I'm going to conclude. The first direction is embarrassment. The Gemara said, "Tze ulmat bakocha shel kedusha." Go and study the power of shame. How dangerous is to make someone else embarrassed? How dangerous is to make someone else? How many times in marriage life, a wife making comments in public, in front of people, in public to embarrass you? A husband making stupid comments to embarrass you? How dangerous we are. If it's anything that we have to accept in ourselves. And the next 9 days is to work, first of all, in idols, to work in our emunah that my wife and my husband, they are the best one for me. My wife is the greatest one. My husband starts with this idol worship, thinking that you can find anything better. Nothing is better outside. The grass of the neighbor just looks good. You just look. You never know. You know what's happened in the second marriage? If the rate of divorce in the second one is 70% of the first marriage, second marriage stands for 85 to 90% divorce. Do you know why? Because in the second marriage, they realize how much the first one was good. Why I was blind? Why I thought that I can kill? I can find. Start with this idol worship. Adultery meaning when you have a relationship, physical relationship. Please, the relationship is physical, but your mind have to be spiritual. You have to bring something to Shah. Yes, let's go up a little. Let's speak a little Kiddusha. And not with this alphabet, ABC. We are much better level. Yes, indeed. You can have, you can go in with your wife and study something before. Study 5 minutes Yom Tov, 10 minutes Yom Tov. You can speak in Shabbat, Divrei Torah. You can go into classes. You can go to the synagogue. Elevate your life, spirituality. You know how nice is that? That your wife is asking, what is this portion of the beach? Can you show me a message for this parasha? Imagine yourself that you have something to answer. Ruby, imagine yourself. Imagine yourself. How many of the queen is asking you, my king, portion, my king, what is this portion of the beach? I don't know, ask the rabbi. No, ask the rabbi. You don't say, I know what Matut was saying, meaning when we have obstacles, we're moving forward. God has given us a message to be happy in life. We are in the 3 weeks, and you share. How beautiful is when the life of a husband and wife become, not a leader, at least 20 to 40% spiritual life. Spiritual, to put some spirituality in this physical marriage. All your life is going to be different. This is idol. This is adultery. Now, the last one is embarrassment. Ladies and gentlemen, I said embarrassment, I'm going to take a class. Two directions. One direction is, remember how dangerous it is to embarrass someone. Our sages said, it's better to die. It's better to jump into the fire and not to embarrass a human being. Nothing is worse from embarrassment. Nothing. This is the simple explanation. How careful you are, especially in public, especially in front of your father and your mother and your, from both sides. Not to make a comment. How many times I said, ladies, don't ask your husband and the Bukharian family to change diaper in front of your father and your mother. Don't embarrass him. Even though that in the house he's doing it because he's a human being, he's a man. Don't do it in front of you. Against tradition. Why do you have to embarrass him? My husband, can you wash the dishes? Can you bring the plate out? Why are you doing it in front? You do it at home, it's okay. He's a human being. You have to be your father. But don't do it in front of the whole community to prove that you know what you're doing, you're embarrassing, you're making him a hero. Not because he's wrong, because this is against something that you grew up with. I'm not saying that he's right or wrong, but do not embarrass. Remember, come on, have on to respect each other. I always said many times, marriage do not build on love. People mistaken, I love you love me, we are happy, my family. It's good for the forcing. when he still had a bottle of flour.